Good morning, sir. My name is Joel Thomas. Today I will be narrating my experience of a successful team project. I will also discuss the key factors that contributed to its success. Last semester, I was part of a group project for my English class. We had to analyze how Gothic literature has evolved over the years and create a presentation on our findings. But there was a twist. We didn't have a leader. Our professor wanted us to manage the project ourselves, which, to be honest, made us a little nervous. From the start, it was clear this wasn't going to be easy. There were three of us and we all had different ideas about how to approach the project. Sarah was really into the Gothic novels like Frankenstein, while Dhruv wanted to focus on modern horror stories. I was somewhere in between, thinking we should cover a bit of everything. We were all passionate, which was great, but it also meant we had a lot of opinions and no clear way to decide which directions to take. One of the hardest parts was making decisions. Without a leader, every choice has to be discussed as a crew. Our meetings were long and sometimes frustrating. We spent hours debating which books to include and how to structure our presentation. At one point, it felt like we are going in circles, revisiting the same arguments over and over again. After a particularly exhausting meeting, we realized we needed a better way to make decisions. So we came up with a system. After discussing an idea, we would take a vote. If the majority agreed, we would move forward. If we were split, we would spend a little bit more time on it, but we had to keep the project moving. It wasn't perfect, but it helped us to stay on track. As we got deeper into the project, I noticed a change in the group. Since we didn't have a leader to rely on, everyone started taking more ownership of their tasks. Sarah, who was passionate about the early Gothic literature, took charge of that section. Dhruv, who had strong opinions about the modern horror, led the research on the contemporary works. I found myself balancing the different perspectives, making sure our analysis connected the past with the present. We also learned to trust each other. We knew that if someone was handling a part of the project, they would do it well. The trust made us more efficient. Instead of second guessing each other, we focused on making our own contribution as strong as possible. It also brought out the best in everyone. People were more creative and willing to take risks because they knew their ideas were valued. On the day of the presentation, we were nervous but also excited. We had put so much into this project and it showed. The slides were well organized and the analysis was thorough. And the multimedia elements really helped bring the evolution of the Gothic literature to life. When we finished the class, applauded, and our professor even mentioned how well we worked together as a team. It was one of the moments where all the hard work really paid off. Looking back, I am really proud of what we accomplished. Working on this self-directed project wasn't easy, but it taught me so much about teamwork and collaboration, and how to navigate group dynamics without a clear leader. It was a challenging experience, but also one of the most rewarding. It showed me that when everyone is committed and trust each other, a group can achieve something truly special. This project didn't just teach me about Gothic literature, it taught me about the collaboration and how to bring the different perspective together to create something greater than the sum of its parts.